Look, we have discussed our same topic, arithmetic progression. Till now, we have so many problems based on our general formulas. There are some problems in APs in which we have. For example, yesterday we have discussed that if our three angles are in AP, then one of the angle is what is the twice the least angle. Then we have solved and find out the angles here. Then again there are some problems in AP in which we have to be select number of terms, 4 terms or 5 terms, and then also relationship between the sum of their squares or product of their numbers are given there. Then in such types of problems when we are going to solve it, so if we are going to take the numbers as like a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d and so on, then to solve the suitable conditions which given in our question, that then it's a little bit difficult to solve it. It's too difficult and it's maybe a little bit lengthy to solve it. Then how can we select the numbers in AP? If we have select 3 numbers, 4 numbers or 5 numbers, we have discussed yesterday to select 3 numbers. If we have to select 3 numbers in an AP, what will our numbers be? A minus D, A and A plus D. This is our three numbers when we have to be select in AP. If we have to select 4 numbers, if we have to select 4 numbers in AP, then what will be our number be? Then our number be like a pattern as A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 2D. If we have to take 4 numbers in AP, then our numbers, the pattern of the number is what? A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. Our 4 numbers are in AP. In our mind, you have to be kept these 3 numbers and 4 numbers, because in general, if the questions from your level is just come from 3 numbers or 4 numbers. And also, if you have if you have to take 5 numbers or 6 numbers, then what you have to do? Just go to the use 1 numbers to the left, to the right, left to the right. For example, if we have to take 5 numbers in AP, we have 3 numbers in AP, A minus D, A plus D. What is the difference there? The difference is what? It's a D difference. Here with 3, we are going to add 1 number here, 1 number here. That what we have? The number as A minus 2D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 2D. Now, we have how many numbers? We have 5 numbers. If we have 6 numbers in AP, we have 4 numbers in AP, then we are going to add 1 number here and 1 number here. Then what is difference there? Difference there is what? 2, then we have the numbers are A minus 5D, A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus 3D and A plus 5D. Then our 6 numbers are like that. Now these are the 3 numbers, 4 numbers, 5 numbers and 6 numbers. Similarly, we are going to find out from here 7 numbers or 8 numbers, adding 1 to the left and adding 1 to the right on the same common differences there. We have the patterns. So whenever we have to take some 3 numbers, 4 numbers, or 5 numbers, or 6 numbers in AP, then we have our selection format of the numbers would be like that. Generally, please focus on 3 numbers are in AP and 4 numbers in AP, because the problems based on your level is belongs to 3 numbers or 4 numbers in AP. Yesterday we have discussed the problem. These are based on 3 numbers in AP. In we have discussed about, if we have 3 numbers in AP in the triangle, then some conditions, find the values. Now today I am going to do questions which belongs to 4 numbers in AP. Find 4 numbers in AP whose sum is 20. We have to find 4 numbers in AP whose sum is 20. We have to find 4 numbers in AP whose sum is given, is given as a 20 and sum of whose squares is 120 and sum of whose squares is 120. We have given there, we have to find four numbers in AP whose sum is 20 and sum of whose squares is 120. Now we have a problem in AP. Four numbers in AP whose sum is 20 and sum of whose squares is 120. Then how can we solve such problem that? Look, what we have discussed, we have, what are four numbers in AP? We have discussed, let four numbers in AP. What is AP? We have A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 3. These are our four numbers in AP. A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 3D. These are four numbers in AP. Now look, we have a four numbers in AP is what? A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 3D. What is given there? Whose sum is 20? What is sum? Sum of this number is 20. Means A minus 3D plus A minus D plus A plus D plus A plus 3D is equal to 20. Now all these D's are cancelled to each other. Now what do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times A is equal to 20. Then from here we get the value of A is what? 5. Now we get our first term is 5. To get this numbers, now we have also required what? Common difference our. How can we get our common difference? We get here our the A is what? The value of A is 5. Now to get our other numbers, sum of now it's given sum of whose squares is 120. Sum of the squares of number is 120. Means also what we have also A plus 3D whole square plus A minus D whole square plus A plus D whole square plus A plus 3D whole square is given 120. Look, we have taken here A minus D because our first number is A minus D. Now, look, what is sum of A plus B whole square and plus A minus B whole square? When we are going to solve in this, this sum is equal to 2 times A square plus B square. Now look, it's A minus B, this is A plus B, and the square sum, we are going to take in the squares of these sums on the basis of this identity. A minus 3B whole square, A plus 3 square is what? Is equal to what? 2 times A square plus 3D whole square means 9D square, sorry, 3D square means it's a 9D square. And when we are taking this A minus B whole square, A plus B square, then it's a 2 A square plus D square. Now is equal to 120. Now 9 to 18 plus this 2 and 2 A square, 2 square. Now we have 4 A square plus 20 D square is equal to 120. And already we have find out the values of A is here. A is 5, then a square of A is what? 25, 25 into 4 what? We have 25 for 100. Then 20 D square is equal to 120 minus this 4 A square means 100. Means 20 D square is equal to 20. From here we get the value of D square is equal to 1. Then D is equal to plus minus 1. Then the value of D is what? Plus minus 1. We get the values of D is what? Plus minus 1. Now we have A equal to 5. We have D is equal to plus minus 1. Then what is our number? 5 minus, when we take plus 1, when we take D is equal to plus 1, then A is 5, 5 minus 3, first number is our 2, 5 minus 1, 4, 5 plus 1, 6, 5 plus 3, 8. When we take plus d, our number is what? 2, 4, 6, 8. When we are going to take d is equal to minus 1, then our 4 numbers is what? It's a minus 1 plus 5 plus 3, 8. Then we get 8, 6, 4, and 2. Means the 4 numbers are in AP whose sum is 20 and sum of whose square is 120 is given by 2, 4, 6, 8 or 8, 6, 4, 2. These are our 4 numbers in AP. Look up. I'm going to again revise this. Look up. We have to find out 4 numbers in AP. It's given in the problem that we have to find the 4 numbers in AP whose sum is what? Whose sum is 20 and sum of whose square is 120. I already explained you that whenever we have to take up 4 numbers in AP, the numbers we have to take 4 numbers in AP like that A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. Now it's given that sum is 20, we have added this number, then we get 4a equal to 20 and after solving we get the value of a is 5. Then also it's given in the problem that the sum of whose squares is 120. It's given that sum of whose squares is 120, then we are going to again also what we have a minus 3d whole square, a minus d whole square plus a plus d whole square plus a plus 3d whole square is equal to 120. Then after solving we know that the sum of anti a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square equal to 2 times a square plus b square. Then we get from here 2 times a square plus 90 square and taking this 2 times a square plus d square, after solving we get 4a square plus 20d square is equal to 120. Now putting the value of a is 5 here, we get 25 into 400, then 20d square is equal to 120 minus 100, 20d square equal to 20, d square equal to 1. Then the value of d is plus minus 1. When we take d is plus 1, our numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8. When we take d is equal to minus 1, then our number is what? 8, 6, 4, 2. And this is our 4 numbers in AP whose sum is 20 and the sum of the square is 120. Now just trying to take another questions of in AP where the numbers of is what? 5 numbers in AP. So suppose we have to take 5 numbers in AP, then what's the problem like that? The questions of 5 numbers of AP is that sorry. Now we are going to take a one question based on 5 numbers and AP. When we have to take 5 numbers on AP, then how can we solve the questions like? It's given the sum of 5 numbers in AP is 30. What is given, sir? Sum of 5 numbers. Sum of 5 numbers in AP. Is 30. Sum of 5 numbers in AP is 30 and the sum of their squares. And sum of their squares is. And the sum of their squares is 220. Now look up. We have a problem based on 5 numbers in AP. It's given that the sum of 5 numbers in AP is 30 and the sum of their squares is 220. It asks us to find its third term. In question that sum of 5 numbers in AP is 30 and sum of the square is 220, then find it third term. Then look, what is the pattern when we have to take 5 numbers in AP? Numbers in AP are, what the pattern? A minus 2D, what we take? A minus 2D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 2D. These are our 5 numbers in AP. What is given there? It's sum of five numbers in A, page 30. In this question, just ask that what is our third number. Then obviously, we are going to solve that. To find the value of A, we get our required solution, but we are not going to find the values of A, just we are going to find out all numbers in here. Then look, according to question, now what we have? Sum is 30 in A minus 2D plus A minus D plus A plus A plus D plus A plus 2D is equal to 30. Now, this is cancelled, 2D to 2D, it's A minus 2D, minus 2D plus 2D cancel out, minus D plus D. Now we have 5A, 5A is equal to 30, then A is equal to 6. According to question, we get our answer because it's asked find third number. Third number is our 6, from here it's a 6, always 6. But we are going to further solve it because we are going to find out all 5 numbers in AP. Then look, what we have? We have A is equal to 6 now. Also given the sum of their squares. Sum of their squares, also what we have? Sum of their squares means A minus 2D whole square plus A minus D whole square plus A square plus A plus D whole square plus A minus, A plus 2D whole square is given 220. What is given? 220. It's a given A minus 2D whole square plus A minus D whole square plus A square plus A plus D whole square plus A plus 2D whole square is what? It's a 220. Now, again we are going to be using our same algebraic identity. The sum of this and this is what? We have 2 times A square plus 4D square. And the sum of this is what? 2 times A square plus D square. Now look what we have. This A square is equal to 220. And what we get? 2A square, 4A square plus. We get 5A square plus 4 to the 8 plus 2, 10. 10D square is equal to 220. Further we can divide by 5. Then what we have? We have A square plus 2B square is equal to 5, 4, 20, 44. The value of A is 6. Then from here, 2D square is equal to what we have? 2D square is equal to 44 minus A square. A square is what? 6, 36. 2D square is equal to 44 minus 36, then what we get? We get 8, means 2D square is equal to 8, then D square is equal to 4, the value of our D square is 4. Now, the value of this, from here what do you get? The value of D is what? The value of D is what? Plus minus 2. From what we get? The value of D is what? The value of D is what? Plus minus 2. Now we get the value of D is plus minus 2. Then we get the value of A is what? We get the value of A is 6 here. Then what are our number there? Then when we take D is equal to 2, then our number is what? 2 to the 4. What is your first number? 6 minus 4, 2. Then what we get there? We get our numbers we get here. What are the numbers is given as? We get the values of, again I am going to revise you. We have to take 5 numbers in AP. We have to take 5 numbers in AP. What is our pattern? To take 5 numbers in AP, we have take our numbers like, let 5 numbers in AP are A minus 2D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 2D.
this our pattern to take 5 numbers in AP. Then when we have take 5 numbers in AP,
it's a minus 2d and a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d, adding, it's given there's a sum of numbers in AP is 30, then we are going to get this number is 30, then 5 plus 30, a is equal to 6, putting this value, we get the value of d is what, plus minus 2, for getting these values, d is equal to plus minus 2, then we are going to put here, then what are numbers, 6, when we take plus 2, 6 minus 4, we get 2, 6 minus 2, we get 4, then 6, then 8, and then 10. When we are going to take d is equal to minus 2, when we are going to take d is equal to minus 2, then what are our values? When we are going to take d is equal to minus 2, then the values of our given by what? We get the number 10, 8, 6, 4, and 2. These are our numbers. Look, what we discussed today class, we have discussed that whenever we have take numbers in AP, the format of numbers is what? We have to be takes 5 numbers as A minus 2D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus, A minus 2D, A minus D, A, then A plus D, A plus 2D. We have to take 5 numbers as, then today we have discussed the numbers pattern which we have to be take in AP problems, which we have take 3 numbers or 5 numbers in AP. We have solved these problems, then look up. Now we have discussed the questions based on 3 numbers and 5 numbers. Let's take another question to solve it. We are going to take some questions from our general formula from next day. Today we are going to start our question based on our sum formula there. Then look, we have discussed questions based on general terms. Now we have to be use sum formula there. Before we are going to sum formula, we are going to do some problems based on general terms formula. Just suppose we have one of the question is that how many multiples of 5 lie between 22 and 272? How many multiples of 5? How many multiples of 5? We have to find out how many multiples of 5 lie between. We have to find out how many multiples of 5 lie between 22 and 272. 22 and 272. We have to find out multiples of 5 lie between 22 and 272. Then how can we find out? First of all, to find out number of multiples of 5, we have to find out what? It's our series of AP. Then lie between 22, then first multiples, multiple of 5 is what? It's our 25, then 30, then we have 35, then 40, and so on. Before 272, what we have? It's a 270. Because the number which ends with 0 is a multiple of 5. Then our last number is what? 270. Now we have a series. We have the numbers starting with 25, 30, 35, 40 and 270. Obviously, this numbers forms an AP, this multiple of 5, this numbers forms an AP. We have find out how many multiples of 5. This side we have explained you. Our last term formula is also as it is, L is given by A plus N minus 1D. This is our last term L. This is our A is first term and common difference obviously multiple of 5 and D is 5 there. Putting this value here, at the place of L put 17, at the place of A putting 25, plus N minus 1, at the place of B put 5. Now, we have 270 is equal to 25 plus 5 and minus 5, 25 minus 5, we get here 20 plus 5 and 270. Further we are going to solve it. Then 5 n is equal to 270 minus 20. Then 5 n equal to 250. From here we get the value of n is 50. The value of n is 50. We get the value of n is 50. What is our problem? We have to solve the multiples of 5. How many multiples of 5 lie between 22 and 32? It's a given by 25, 30, 35, 40 and 270. What do we find out? When we
have known our last term, then we are going to use the formula as L is equal to A plus N minus 1D.
Then we find out the values of this. The number of multiples of how many multiples of 5 there between 22 and 272 is 50. There are 50 numbers between this 22 and 272.
Now look up. Let's take another question. The angles of a quadrilateral are in AP and the greatest angle is thrice the least angle. Again, look up.
It's a question, it belongs to what? Today we have discussed when we have to take a 3 numbers or 4 numbers. Today we have discussed that what the numbers we have to take in the AP. It's a 3 or 4 numbers. It's question from that. It's given that the angles of a quadrilateral are in AP. How many angles are in quadrilateral? Yes. How many angles are we have? Yes, we have 4 angles. We have 4 angles in AP. Then how can we take the angles?
Late angles of a quadrilateral. What is the pattern? It's A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus D. These are 4 numbers which we have to take in of our numbers in AP. But we take like, because we have to take angles there, angles of quadrilateral.
Let the 4 angles of a quadrilateral be given by A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D.
Now look, what is given that? And the greatest angle is thrice the least angle.
Obviously, this is our greatest, this is our least angle. What is given? Greatest is 3 times least. Means A plus 3D is equal to 3 times A minus 3D. We are going to solve this. Then we have A plus 3D is equal to 3A minus 9D. Then what we have? We have 2A is equal to 12D. Then from here we get A is equal to 6D. But we have to find out angles. How can we find out? What is our next equation there? Yes. It's given that this is angles of quadrilateral. Then their sums must be equal to what? Yes.
They are sums of A minus 3D plus A minus D plus A plus D plus A plus 3D must be equal to 360 degree, because this represent the angles of a quadrilateral. Now what we have? This all these terms are cancelled to each other. Then we have 4A is equal to 360. And from here we get the value of A is what? 90. Put in here. 90 is equal to 6D, then the value of D is what? 90 by 6, 30 by 2, then D is equal to, we get the D is 15 degree. Now we have the value of A, we have the value of D, then what is our angles?
Then our angles are A minus 3D, 3 into 15, 45, 90 minus 45, 45. A minus D, 90 minus 15, what do we have here? 60, A plus D, 105, A plus D, 105, minus 3D, minus 2D, and then plus D, and then we have 19D is 5, 105, A minus D, then we have done mistake here. Because 90, 10, 80 and 5, it's what? We get, because A minus 3D, we have A minus D, 90 minus 50, what we have? We have 75. Now,
Then 1 into 5, and what is our last? A plus 3d, 45. 90 plus 45, what do we get? 135. These are our angles of a quadrilateral. 45, 75, 105, and 135. Okay guys, this is enough for today class. Thanks to all.